G'day guys, and welcome back to another episode of The Natural Herp Keeper. And today we are coming from the very windy, chilly beach in the absolutely gorgeous Iron Range National Park in Cape York, Australia. And in this episode, guys, we're going to be traveling through Iron Range, and we're going to bring you along so you can see what cool herps we can find while we're out here. Now, we drove in last night. We were lucky enough to actually get two green pythons on the way in. Okay, so it's been a great start, and the weather's a little bit overcast. We've had a few showers, a bit of rain around. It's actually a lot warmer than previous years when I've been here at this time, so I'm hoping that means we are going to be up for an epic adventure and find some wicked herps. So make sure you hang around, guys, and stay tuned to see what we can find. Thank you.
Alrighty guys, so I'm just walking along the road edge here through the Iron Range National Park and check out what I've just come across. This is one of the main targets that we were looking for. Look at that Aussie green python. They are stunning. This one does have a couple of scars, looks like it's been in the wars a little bit there. Check it out, guys. Now this is actually the sixth one we've found for the trip. This is number four for tonight as well, which is pretty wicked. Okay, so we've just climbed up to the top of the embankment where we've just found one of the green pythons that we saw last night that was sitting in ambush. We've actually found it curled up in the treetops here this afternoon. And check this out, okay? So this is actually a passion fruit vine that's growing on the edge of this little creek. And as you can see, the passion fruits all through here have been eaten by, I'm assuming, small mammals, maybe melamis, little rats, mice. And that's exactly where this green has decided to set up his home. So check this out, guys, as we come through. Look at him. So he will be sitting up here through the day, just chilling out, relaxing. And then each night he'll go down to where we saw him last night, sitting in ambush. That is pretty damn amazing to be able to find this guy through the day as well. It's pretty wicked.
So we're just back at one of the spots where we saw a green perched last night, and we've actually been able to spot him up in the canopy. So I'm just going to quickly show you the sort of habitat that they're living in. This is what most of it looks like. This is the branch or little sapling where this one was perched and ambushed last night. And if we look right up here through the canopy, we can just spot him up there. Now, interestingly, a lot of them have been perched on these really thin branches. So nothing really thick, it's all these really tiny thin ones that they seem to be choosing.
Alright, so we're back at one of the spots where we saw three green pythons last night, and we've come for a bit of a walk back through the rainforest this morning. And check it out, we've got another one of them perched up through the day. Now this one's not even sitting on a vine, it is literally sitting on a pile of folded up leaves. It's quite content sitting up in the top of the canopy there. Get in a bit closer. So it's probably 3 meters, 3.5 meters up in the tree. And if we zoom back out, come down here, there's a couple of fresh snake turds over there as well, and a couple of not so fresh ones. So it's obviously a fairly highly populated area for them here. This guy must have set up residence again. Lots of chewed on fruit, plenty of little malamies, rats, mice getting around in here, and just perfect green python habitat. Look at that. Hey guys, so we're just in this little clearing checking out some of the green pythons from last night that we've seen perched. I'm just looking down at the creek here, and check out what we've just got swimming past us right over here. It's a little bit far for the camera to pick up. We've just got a McClay's cruising around in the shallows here, catching a little fish hopefully. This place is absolutely amazing. There's just wildlife wherever you look. Okay guys, so that's where we were before. I've just climbed across to the other side of the bank, and I'm just walking along the edge here, and check it out. Oh, that reflection's really in the wrong spot. But there's a McClay's just sitting in ambush right there with these fish swimming right past its head pretty much. Now I'm pretty sure that's a different McClay's to the one I just saw a second ago. It looks much larger. I'm trying to get down there for you. Look at that. Wicked. I'm pretty sure most of those fish are far too big to be food for this guy, so they're not worried about him perched in there at all. But seriously guys, how awesome is this place? Look at that. Wicked. You're not gonna believe it, but while I was down there watching the other McClay's, Jake found this little dude just cruising around up here as well. Thank you.
Alright guys, so what we're looking at now while we're wandering around Chile Beach here, in amongst the mangroves and the boulders on the edge of the ocean here, and what we've got are these gorgeous snake-eyed skinks, the coastal snake-eyed skink. Can you see them chirping out in there? And these are all over these rocks out here, so little guys are just darting in and around, and they've made a great home in amongst these coastal rocks, mangroves, right on the beachfront.
Okay, that wraps up part one of our Iron Range herping trip. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe buttons and the little notification bell so you're alerted when part two comes out. And we'll see you next time on another episode of The Natural Herp Keeper.